Google Merchants issue, image too small. What can you do to resolve it? In this video, I'm going to explain to you exactly what's causing this issue, why Google is throwing you this error, image too small, and what are actually Google's requirements for your product images, and how you can fix this issue so you can get your products approved as soon as possible and start getting Google Shopping traffic. Hi, I'm Clarice Lin, the ROI doctor who helps small businesses and online stores get more traffic and sales by getting on Google and YouTube page one. If you're new to this channel and you have some problems on your Google Merchants account that's causing it to be suspended or your products to be disapproved, you might want to check out my playlist here, entire playlist on how you can resolve or misrepresentation or excessive capitalization of your products. So these are some of my videos that you can check it out. Link is in the top right hand corner. Having a Google Merchant Center account is one of the three components to get your products listed for free on Google Shopping. So whether it is that you have a Shopify or WooCommerce store, then you need to have a Google Merchant Center account and a Google Ads account, and all of this needs to be linked, talking to one another, so you can get this latest product information listed on Google. And one of the biggest problems that many merchants like yourself is facing, one of these issues, is image too small. The reason for having all of these strict guidelines that Google have is because Google wants to compete with Amazon for the e-commerce space. Google wants merchants to show good product information and accurate information and having a good, presentable, trustworthy front for Google users or potential buyers. So the next time that anyone wants to buy something, they will think, oh, I'm going to go to Google Shopping because there are many products listed there. That's Google's ultimate aim. So in order to support that, you might want to present your store in the best possible light and submitting all the possible information for your product, so Google feels like this store owner has a good storefront, customers can trust this store, you have all this information, shipping, store information, contact information, all the products are listed correctly. And of course, one of the most important part of the product information is having a good product image. Users or buyers can't see your product image, then they will not likely going to buy at all. The product image is a most as important as the product title itself in order to sell your products. So you want to have a good image. When I say a good image, I don't mean just uploading any random JPG file like JPEG or image file. It needs to be of high quality, meaning that people can see it clearly. It can't be a blurry photo. People can see the details on your products. That's very straightforward, isn't it? Unfortunately, not many people realize it, and Google has actually expressively put all of this information out on this page. I'm going to show you exactly right here. Let's have a quick look onto my computer. I'm going to show you the page where Google states about this image too small criteria, what exactly they're looking at. So let's head onto my computer quickly. Let's check it out. We're now here on Google Merchant Center help page. I'm going to highlight a couple of details here. I'm going to look through Google's instructions and read between some of the lines so you actually know what Google is ultimately looking for. How to fix image too small. The highlight of the entire issue is you need to fulfill this criteria by having product images that are at least 100 times 100 pixels for non-clothing products and 250 times 250 pixels for clothing products. That's the minimal requirements. For clothing products, they require a slightly higher pixel, mainly because they want the customers to have a better feel of how the material is looking like and kind of be able to see certain details if there are certain product designs. If you, for example, if you have like zigzag design, polka dots, intricate details, if it's 100 times 100, the customers will not be able to see it in detail. So make sure all of your, if you're selling cloth or anything, clothes and accessories, make sure you have 250 times 250 pixels. As you can see here, Google reiterates, if it's too small to be used in an ad or free listing, they're going to reject it. One of the things I want to highlight is even though they want images which have the details for the customers to be able to see them, the file size of your images can't be larger than 60 megapixels. If your file sizes are too big, Google needs more resources on their site to be able to pull these photos for the customers to show on Google Shopping. So they don't want the file size to be too big, they want it just to be precisely big enough. So they are not accepting any file sizes that is bigger than 60 megabytes, do check your file size. If it's being rejected, if that's one of the reasons, you have to reduce the file size. And they don't want you to enlarge your images, because if you're actually enlarging your pictures itself, meaning that you're pulling the four corners of your images, what happens is you are making it bigger, so to speak, but it's not clear. There is no clarity in those images, so that's not allowed. This bullet point basically means that they don't want your pictures to be small, you shouldn't be scaling up your images, or thumbnails, which is very, very small images of your product pictures. What Google is actually expecting, they know that customers rely on product images to make their decision when shopping online, as what I've kept reiterating throughout the entire video. Images are very, very important, so they will disapprove items when they don't include an image with the right dimensions. All your products should have the right image, and the image should be clear enough. By staying within the size dimensions, Google is able to show all these images in the best possible light when they put it on Google Shopping. If you're not having the right image dimensions for clothing and non-clothing products, what happens is it could look distorted on Google Shopping. So they want to make sure that it has the minimal dimension. Let's say if you have a clothing that is like 250 times 300 pixels, it's allowed. Basically, it needs to be the length and the breadth by itself. It needs to be at least 250 times 250. It doesn't need to be precisely 250 times 250. It can be one of the dimensions, can be slightly bigger, but it needs to be at least 250. That goes the same for other products that are non-clothing products. It could be 100 times 200. Or 200 times 150, that's fine. It just needs to be above 100. So you need to keep within the size dimension to make sure that your product is ready to appear to customers who view your ads or free listing. In order to see which are the affected products, Google has also given some instructions over here. So you can look through the instructions over here to see how to see which are the products that do not fulfill the exact requirements. On the main menu under diagnostics, under products, you can see that there is a, they will show you how many products are being affected. But if you want to precisely get into the details, you can go to products diagnostics to see which, how many products and which are the URL for those products. So you can go back to either Shopify or WooCommerce to replace your photos. Once you have resubmitted the correct specifications for your images, then you have to make sure that this is updated in the URL image underscore link, which is the column name accepted by Google to retrieve those images. This is the name of the column that Google uses to extract the images of each product. And if you have more than one image, then additional underscore image underscore link is the URL that you will put. You can have more than one URL over there for alternative images that you might have of your products from different angles. So that will be really useful. And once you are sure that all of these are ready to go, you can resubmit them. If you have an automated feed, then you don't have to worry about resubmitting them, because then Google will automatically go to your Shopify, WooCommerce, or Magento products to pull those updated images. If you don't have an automated feed set up, you have like a spreadsheet, then you might have to refresh it manually for Google to resolve these issues. This is the other page where we get more information about what is expected for the images. To add on what I've mentioned earlier, make sure that your images can be accessed by Google. You can check your robots.txt if you have any issues. Google is repeating what they have said earlier in the previous help page. They want your image to accurately display the product that you are selling. As you can see, it's very clear. And there is an accepted file format that they are looking for. Accepted file formats are JPEG, .jpg, or .jpeg, WebP, PNG, non-animated GIF, .gif, .bmp, and TIFF. So these are the file formats that are accepted. Any other formats will not be accepted. So if you have an error with the new file that you are uploading, then please go back to check the file format and resave it in the right accepted format. Another thing I want to highlight is the exclusion of promotional text. Please don't add any text that says buy now, free. They don't want any promotional text, no watermarks on your images, and no borders around your entire image. Just needs to be the picture of the product itself. please don't become fancy or add additional things that are non-essential. If you don't have the photos of your images yet, then most likely your product will be disapproved because Google wants every product that's shown on Google Shopping listing to have the right accurate image. So they tell you, please do not submit a placeholder or generic image that doesn't describe what the product is about. The only exception that they give is written here, which says in the hardware, vehicles and parts section, so they would accept illustrations. Aside from that, they want a real life photo of the product that you're selling. If you have more than one image for your products, then you would utilize this column, which is additional underscore image underscore link for additional products. They allow you to submit up to 10 other pictures of your products. So if you have different angles of your products, or if you have like a bag and then you want to submit a picture of how it looks like from the inside, you can use this column to submit up to 10 additional pictures, which means that for each product that you're selling, up to 11 pictures can be submitted. So please choose the best ones that you have. If you only have one picture, then you need to just worry about this one column, image underscore link, which is a required attribute. The additional image link is an optional. So if you don't have more than one picture, that's fine. But otherwise, if it's going to help your customers make a better decision, they might go, wow, okay, this looks really cool. If I see all the images, then I'll highly recommend you to submit more images, as many as possible, different angles, up to 10, to help customers to decide to buy.
Now you know the full criteria for the product images, the specifications for non-clothing product images and clothing product images, and you know the file size, minimal and maximal file size, and the file format, then what do you need to do next? You need to change and update the pictures. First thing is, if you actually already have high resolution photos somewhere and you have accidentally just compressed those photos so it became really blurry, then not to worry, just go back to your folder and upload those high quality photos. If the file size is larger than 64 megabytes, then what you can do is to use a couple of different tools. I'm going to put the tools down in the description and pinned comments where you can actually compress your photos but still keeping the high resolution. Is just reducing the file size, so Google will accept your file size if it's bigger than 64 megabytes for each of your photos. After you have optimized those photos by reducing the file size and keeping the quality of the image, then upload it up. Then what if you don't actually have high quality photos? I'm afraid then you have to go back to take high quality pictures of those photos. If you are a retailer and manufacturers are the ones who's providing you with the photos, then you can go back to them and ask them if they have high quality images that you can use and promote for your store. So go back and ask them for those images, tell them the specification that Google is looking for, and then get those images. And once you have those images, if the file dimensions is not correct, what you can do is to resize them as what Google has listed. It's 100x100 or 250px x 250px. If you have only a couple of products, you can do it manually. Go to Canva, create a free account, state the dimensions itself that you want, you upload the photos, and then you can pull to make sure that it fits to the exact size of the canvas. Once it's done, you can download each of them and then you can upload it to your online store. If your image spec is not big enough, maybe you need some borders or some white space, you can also use Canva and then you can create some white spacing around it. Don't enlarge your photos by pulling the corner of the photos to make it bigger, because details of the products can't be seen. The only way you can enlarge your image without compromising your file resolution is only if you have a high quality photo to start with. If your photo is of low quality, then please don't increase the size of the image by pulling at the corners, because what you're doing is your resolution actually goes down and Google knows that, and then your image will not have fulfilled Google's criteria, so that's going to be a no-go and you'll be rejected. Typically, it takes about 30 minutes to 1 hour for Google Merchant account to retrieve the latest information from your store. So you don't have to worry, you don't have to keep staring at it. Once that's updated, then those errors will automatically go away. Checks for image too small is usually automated, so you don't have to wait for too long. So for other errors that you might have, for example, suspension or website needs improvement, those errors typically needs a request for review, and someone actually goes to look at your store and review everything and your setup. That's a different video that you can also check out. I have it right here, website needs improvement, link is on the top right hand corner. Or the misrepresentation of self and product, you can also check out my video right here, link is in the top right hand corner. It's not difficult to get your products approved and to be listed on Google as long as you're providing all the correct information, correct product images. And if you're ready to get more traffic to your store but not ready to run ads yet, you can also check out my other video right here about how to drive more traffic without running ads for your store. You can check it out, link is in the top right hand corner. And of course, if you want to know of even more ways to get more traffic to your store and to examine the pros and cons, right strategy for getting more traffic, you can check out my Shopify marketing guide, link in the description and pinned comment, where I explore the pros and cons of the best ways that you can get more traffic to your store according to your budget and according to your project planning. So do check that out. And if you need guided one-on-one support, I help small businesses and online stores get more traffic and sales. Check out my services in the description and pinned comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, found it informative, please give it a like, subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss future videos on how to get more traffic and sales to your online store. I'm Clarice Lin, the RI Doctor, signing off. I'll see you in the next video. Bye. I'm not the one who's always right.